to Objex TV. We are living in an API economy. When implementing capabilities, the design of the services must start with externally visible service contract, or known as specifications or OpenAPI specifications. API is a contract that all parties need to follow exactly. Changing such a contract is always difficult, and this makes the design of an API extremely important. The industry standard for REST API definition is the OpenAPI specifications. OpenAPI specifications are renamed from Swagger specifications to OpenAPI specifications in 2015. And OpenAPI specs allows you to describe your API, including available endpoints that are exposed for external applications and operations on each endpoint, for example, GET, POST. Operation parameters input and output for each operation can be described in OpenAPI specifications as well. Authentication methods, how to authenticate and use your APIs. You can also add your corporate information, terms of use, and all that kind of information and meta information. API specifications can be written in YAML or JSON format. Writing specification in YAML is highly recommended. I have used Swagger Editor and Hub in the past, and they are contributed by SmartBeer. You can use it free, or you can get the Swagger Editor Edition, which is a subscription-based. Various parts of a well-defined API specifications are API general information that you can write down the title of your application, your API version. We recommend using semantic versioning, like 1.0.0. I will describe how the semantic versioning works in another video. API description. This is arbitrary text, and a description could be any text that you can write down to define what is inside the API. You can also describe the terms of service, and the terms of service must be in a URL format pointing to a URL, external URL, or your own website. You also add the contact information of the developers, where you have name, email, a support email, a support URL contact. Then you can also name the license, a URL to the license description. In license, you can pretty much describe that, for example, it's Apache license or use MIT license. And you can also link the API specification with the external documentation. Under the auth description, You can define the bearer authentication, for example, that meaning give access to the bearer of this token. The bearer token is a cryptic string usually generated by the server in response for a login request. Schemas is an object to hold a reusable data schema used across definitions. So once we define the object, we can reusable using the reference, and we'll see that there's an update on this as well. Responses. An object to hold reusable components, status codes and their references, parameters, an object to hold reusable parameters you are using throughout your API requests. Examples, an object to hold reusable examples, requests and responses to use in your design. Request bodies, an object to hold reusable bodies that will be sent with your API request. Headers, an object to hold reusable headers that define the HTTP structure of your requests. Security schemas, an object to hold security paths can be defined this way. So simple, slash, path, and then you have a definition. OpenAPI 3 supports get, post, put, patch, delete, head, options, and trace methods. To illustrate form data, consider an HTML post form. So this is your standard HTML form, how the form looks like. Then you have this form post data get posted to an endpoint that defined within our API specifications. Although we created an API layer between multiple channels, so we can use a unified commerce or composable commerce approach where we use API first to learn what is available, and all the channels can utilize those APIs. You can find this video in article format below. This video is sponsored by Rebito. Rebito works as your social media marketing hub. See the link below to sign up and take advantage of a very special discount today. Please like and subscribe if you'd like to see more videos like this one.